Hi everyone, I have come to answer this question that has raised a lot of concern to all my viewers all over the world. People have been asking, who is Majaliwa? My official name is Majaliwa Machinda, but I've been known by other names like Aaron Majaliwa Machinda, Mlongecha, Mwenetombwe. Those are long Bantu names. Who is Majaliwa? If you look at my face, I'm not that young. I should be in middle age. Majaliwa is a husband. Majaliwa is a father of 5 children, 3 girls and 2 boys. Majaliwa is a singer, is a guitarist. Majaliwa is a preacher and a campaigner of the truth of the Bible, the truth that has been hidden for many years. Majaliwa is a Pan-Africanist. He's an author and, very importantly, a Bantu Israelite. What do I believe? Very many people have been asking me questions regarding singing praise and worship, which I've been doing for the last 20 years, and just few videos are uploaded on YouTube. Looking into the videos that I've been posting recently, preaching about the hidden truth of the Bible, and now some people think I'm doing double standard or some work which is opposite from each other. No, I am praising the Most High through songs of praise and worship and spreading the truth that has been hidden by the colonizers. The only issue is that we have been led to believe the opposite of the truth, and people think Jesus is a white man. No, Jesus was not a white man. Jesus was black.
He was not a white man. He was not a white man.
What I believe is that biblical Israel is in sub-Saharan Africa. What I believe is that Bantu people are the biblical Israelites. If you begin to read your Bible very well, you will agree with me that Israelites of the Bible were not light-skinned. They were rather dark-skinned, and they were taught to be many as the sand of the seashore. And that's the reality we are living today. If you look at sub-Saharan Africa, it has got a lot of features that are in the Bible compared to the Middle East or Europe or America or any other place. When you see me singing, I sing with a conviction that our Savior is within us, is not a white man.
So when are white Christians gonna admit that if Jesus showed up in America in 2020, he would be a black man shot by the police? Think about it. He literally was a black man, and he was murdered by his judicial system because he went against the system of power that was oppressing people.
When I sing, I believe that Israel is in Africa. So many churches are full now of confusion. People think the biblical Israel is in Middle East. No, it's in Africa. So when I sing songs of praise and worship, when I preach or I give this awakening campaign speeches, it's all the same thing, aiming at awakening people. When my fellow singers out there sing, when my fellow preachers preach there, they should be convinced that what we have been told by the colonizers is a lie. And the truth is, Israel is in Africa. When I sing, don't quote me wrong. When I preach, don't quote me wrong either. Because what I'm doing is just one thing, praising the Most High and telling you to understand the truth. I can challenge you one moment. People who came to Africa, especially to my place, to Congo, and cut my ancestors their hands and put in the sacks and took them to Belgium, and you still believe that those people who enslaved us still can preach the good news to us, still can tell us the truth? No, they won't tell us the truth. Otherwise, if they tell us the truth, we shall know the truth and we shall be free. And they don't want us to be free. That's why I sing to praise the Most High, and I also preach to tell you to turn to the truth. The land in Middle East is just a hoax, is just a formation to distort the gospel, to distort the scriptures. And if you've been following my videos, you will realize that I've been trying to describe the culture of the Bible in conjunction with what the Bantu people do. And if you have time to watch them, watch and just not believe, but try to understand and do your research in order to discover the truth.